The frantic rush inside an emergency room was a common sight at the height of the COVID-19 crisis in America. But despite billions being spent on vaccine development, success remains on the line.
It is spreading more efficiently, and it's causing a lot of disease and a lot of stress.
In the last week, U.S. cases have increased by 47% across more than two dozen states, with a third of all new infections coming from just five states.
I'm not asking you to not go enjoy your life. I'm asking you to please be careful.
In Missouri, the state's midsummer surge is outpacing last winter's, with the majority of patients in hospital unvaccinated. Hesitancy and resistance is a growing problem, now being made worse by news of a rare neurological syndrome, Guillain-Barré. The FDA has tied to the Johnson & Johnson shot.
Some are left with a disability and occasionally can be severe enough that there are complications. Now, curiously, many patients then reverse the syndrome after a period of time.
Of more than 12 million doses, around 100 suspected cases and one death have been identified. The vaccine isn't used in Canada. American regulators say evidence suggests an association, but note data is preliminary. The syndrome has also been inconsistently associated with flu vaccines.
There are treatments that can arrest the progress or certainly slow it down.
J&J has already been scrutinized over a risk for blood clots and manufacturing. Now, health experts are concerned about optics and what this could do to shaky confidence.
We run the risk here, if we don't pivot quickly away from J&J, of having a sustained carryover effect, really damaging the reputation and the image of the mRNA vaccines.
Health experts still insist that in all approved vaccines, the benefits outweigh risks and that protection remains the key to a clean bill of health. Reggie Cicchini, Global News, Washington.